Bismillahi walhamdulillahi wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillahi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama tasliman kathiran alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. On this third beautiful evening, this third beautiful day of Ramadan, we have alhamdulillah the third chapter. And this is Surah Ali Imran. And this chapter has 200 ayat verses. And we're told that ma'na ismiha, the meaning behind the name Imran, that Imran rajulun salihun min bani Israel, that it's basically a proper name for a man who was from among the Hebrews, from among the children of Israel. Wal muradu bi ali Imran, and what's meant by ali Imran, the family of Imran, is Isa alayhi salatu wasalam wa ummuhu Maryam alayhi salatu wasalam wa Yahya alayhi salatu wasalam. So the three main folks who are really the focus here is Isa, his mother Maryam, and Yahya. May Allah Ta'ala be pleased with all of them. Sababu tasmiyatiha. Why is it named this way? We're told dhikratu qissati Ali Imran, because Allah Ta'ala specifically mentions the family of Imran and basically recounts to us, tells us about them. He basically gives us a story in a story form that which reflects on their lives. وَدَلَالَةُ هَذَا الْإِسْمِ عَلَى الْمَقْصَدِ الْعَامِ لِسُورَةِ وَمَوْضُعَاتِهَا. And because in the sense, the name is a reflection of the general sense of what the, you know, objectives of what the chapter is focusing on, and what it also is going to contain of the different subjects within it. أَسْمَاؤُهَا, the names for this chapter. اشتهرت بسورة آل عمران. So naturally it is famously known by Surah Ali Imran. وتسمى سورة الكنز. It is also known as the chapter of الكنز, the treasure. وسورة الأمان, and the chapter of safety, the chapter of guarantee. وَتُلَقَّبُ بِالزَّهْرَاءِ, and it is also known as الزَّهْرَاء in the same way that Al-Baqarah was mentioned as that beautiful emanating light, so beautiful light. مَقْصِدُهَا الْعَامِ, what is the general objective? We're told بَيَانُ الْأَدِلَّةِ وَالْبَرَاهِينَ عَلَى وِحْدَانِيَّةِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. So the first thing is that there's evidence and proofs for Allah Ta'ala's oneness, making the point, reaffirming the fact that Allah is one. وَأَحْكَامِ الْجِهَادِ وَغَيْرِ, as well as some other rulings dealing with the with jihad, with physical armed struggle, and other things. وَرَدِّ شُبُهَاتِ النَّصَارَ, as well as addressing some of the specious arguments of the Christians, the arguments that they've made in different ways, and Allah Ta'ala addressing them one by one. سَبَبُ نُزُولِهَا, the reason why the verse, the chapter was revealed. First we're told أَنَّهَا سُورَةٌ مَدَنِيَّةٌ, it is a Medinan chapter. وَلَمْ يُنْقَلْ سَبَبٌ لِنُزُولِهَا جُمْلَةً وَاحِدَةً. We don't have anything that specifically tells us about it being revealed all at once, why that would have been the case. وَلَكِنْ صَحَّ لِبَعْضِ آيَاتِهَا سَبَبُ نُزُولٍ. But we do have for certain verses within it a specific reason why they were revealed. فَضْلُهَا, its virtues, its merits. We have two specifically that are told to us. And this first one is collected by Imam Muslim. We're told تُحَاجُ عَنْ صَاحِبِهَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, that it is going to be basically like a defense for its you know, the person on the Day of Judgment. قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ اِقْرَأُ زَهْرَوَيْنِ الْبَقَرَةَ وَآلِ عِمْرَانِ فَإِنَّهُمَا تَأْتِيَانِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. So we'll break this up. He said, صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ, in the command, imperative form, read the two beautiful lights, Al-Baqarah and Ali Imran, because for sure the two of them will come on the day of resurrection. كَأَنَّهُمَا غَمَامَتَانِ, they're going to come as though they are two clouds, right? أو كأنهما غيايتان أو كأنهما فرقان من طير صواف. And again, he's mentioned as though they're going to be two forms, like two, like غيايتان, like two mists, two fogs. or that they're going to come as two legions of birds that are going to be arranged and that are going to be in ranks. What are they going to do? تُحَاجَّانِ عَنْ صَاحِبِهِمَا. That these two chapters are going to be there at the defense of the person who has learned them, who has memorized them, who has lived by the guidance and teachings in them. They're going to be there to say, basically speak up in the defense of the person, to tell them, to say, Allah, this person has read, this person has studied, this person has been transformed by the guidance that you have given in them. The second is hiya min as-sab', that it is from the first seven chapters of the Qur'an, of which the Prophet ﷺ taught us, that whoever learns them, that they are a scholar. The eighth and final point, Ahbab, is munasabatuha. We're told that munasabatu awwali surati Ali Imran bi akhiriha. What is the connection between the beginning of the chapter with the end of the chapter? Al-hadithu anil kutubi samawiyati wal-isharatu ilayha. So we're told that basically the focus is on divine books, basically scriptures, and what there is of guidance, of what they are calling to of attention. فَقَالَ فِي فَاتِحَتِهَا نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقُّ. He's telling the Prophet ﷺ that it is Allah who has certainly set down to you the book in truth, with truth. وَقَالَ فِي خَاتِمَتِهَا. And he said in the end of it, وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ. And that which has been sent down to you, and that which has been sent down to them. Again, the connection of revelation that Allah Ta'ala has given to the Prophet ﷺ, the Qur'an, and he has given to the previous messengers other books, other scripture. The second point is munasabatu surati Ali Imran lima qablaha min surati al-Baqarah. So how is Ali Imran tied into al-Baqarah? ذِكْرُ دُعَاءِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي خَوَاتِيمِ سُورَةِ الْبَقَرَةِ وَفِي أَوَّلِ سُورَةِ آلِ عِمْرَانِ. So what we find is that the end of al-Baqarah is that dua, right? The dua that the believers are making. And the beginning of Ali Imran has in it the dua also. So subhanAllah, there's this connectedness that shows that the supplications of the believers, which are there from the beginning, from the end of Surah al-Baqarah, as well as in the beginning. And in that we see that subhanAllah, that is a strong, beautiful common thread that weaves these two chapters together. And Allahu Azza wa Jal knows best, as he is the most beautiful, the most knowledgeable, the most wise of all that he has revealed in the Qur'an. We ask him Jalla wa Ala that he teach us of it, that which we are ignorant of, and that he remind us what we have forgotten, and that he help us to truly learn and put into action so that we are transformed by the guidance of the Qur'an. Allahumma ameen. Wa salli Allahumma wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'een.